ang atong hinigugma una mga konselebrante sa atong misa, atong igsoong obispo gikan pa sa San Jose, California, Most Reverend Oscar Cantu. Atong tinawad obispo auxiliar, Emerito Bishop Tony Raniola. Atong hinigugma, mga kapariang Agustino, Monsignor John Limchua, atong sekretaryo sa Secretary of State, og tanang mga kaparian Agustino, Relioso, mga diocesano. Pakpak na lanay kay members sa religious communities, consecrated life, devotos og devotas ni Señor Santo Niño, mga bisita, og tanan nga uban nato sa atong misa, lain-laing social media platforms, sugad man ang tanan nga dini sakop sa Pilgrim Center, ag daghang sa gawas, ug ang tanan nga namamati, usbo nato broadcast sa atong misa. Kaninyong tanan sa ngalan sa Archdiocese, gusto nako ipadangat ninyo ang atong malipayong pagbati. Happy Fiesta natong tanan. Viva Señor Santo Niño!
Viva Pit Señor!
Mga kaigsunan, usbo nato kining atong misa, atong gihalad alang sa inyong katuyuan, katuyuan sa atong hermano o hermana. Pagkanindot hunahunaon nga daghan kita gitigom sa Ginoo, human ang tulo ka tuig nga gidumili ang panagtigom physical tungod sa COVID. Karong adlawa, nindot hunahunaon minilyon ka mga devotos nagkatigom. Kahapon, fluvial procession, foot procession, o karong adlawa, lain-laing misa din sa atong basilika o sa atong pilgrim center. Kanyong tanan nga naghatag panahon kang Señor Santo Niño, kang Mama Mary, daghan kaayong salamat. Ang tema karong tuiga atong mabasa, Santo Niño, Fountain of Peace in our Journey of Hope, of Faith. Mga hinigugma, Journey of Faith. Padayon ang atong lakaw sa pagtuo. Makainumdum kita 1521 to 2021, and 9 years before 2021, nagsaulog kita 500 YOC, 500 years of Christianity, og nahuman kini Abril 2021. Pero tungod kay limitado ang mga aktibidades gin padayon Year of Grace 2022, og gi-conclude December 31, 2022. Kining tanan, gihimaya nato ang Dios og gipasalamatan tungod sa gasa sa pagtuo nga atong nadawat 500 years ago hangtod karong panahon na. Faith, Journey of Faith. O guman naman 500 YOC and Year of Grace ang hagit natong tanan, padayon kita sa lakaw sa pagtuo. And in this journey of faith, today we declare Señor Santo Niño is our companion, source of, fountain of peace in our journey of faith. Mga kaigsunan, sa atong pagbaliktanaw, makaingon kita. Kining journey, kining panaw sa pagtuo, dili sayon. Daghang panahon sa pagsulay. Tinuo dunay panahon sa kalipay. Bisan lamang tulo ka tingali, sakit kayo nga pagsulay. October 15, 2013, ang kita din ni makahinumdom kining belfry sa basilika tungod sa linog na tumpag. Yes. Subo tanawon kining atong basilika ni Señor Santo Niño tungod sa linog na tumpag. And yet, makaingon kita, Señor Santo Niño, tuburan sa kalipay, paglaom sa pagsulay. Karon kung atong tanawon, wa ganig makahinomdom nga natumpag kining belfry. Amen. Salamat kay Señor Santo Niño. The past 3 years, COVID struck the whole world. Ag dinhi nato, sakit kaayo. Mao nga bisan sa religious, cultural, educational, social, economic nga tanan. No? Subo ang atong kinabuhi. And yet, padayon kita maingon, Señor Santo Niño, tuburan sa kalipay, paglaom sa pagsulay. Karong adlawa sa atong panagtigom, tingali, may napanabilin gamay nga COVID, no? Pero gamay na lang. No? Nag-Pispas pagani mo kami. Asahay Pispas, asahay wa. Excuse lang mo ako Pispas kaya di ako makabasa kay na-fag, no? Pero prayon lang ka mo. Pero bisan pa na ay COVID, no? Na makaingon ako, na-smile lang ka mo. No? Nakita na ako, nag-smile ka mo diha, no? Bisan naka-Pispas. Amen. Salamat, Señor Santo Niño, tuburan sa kalipay, paglaom sa pagsulay. Amen?
Amen.
Nangagi si Udet, beginning of Aguinaldo Mass last year. No? Subo kayo, mga simbahan nga natumpag, mga panimalay nga naglupan. Pero, mao kini ang gasa ni Señor Santo Niño, nasalig kita nga bisan pa taliwala sa daghang mga pagsulay tungod siyang gugma barog Cebu tinabangay kita og karon ang makabisita dinhi makaingon daw di naman makita masyado ang epekto ni Odette. Amen.
Amen.
Mingon kita tungod kay Mama Mary. Nag-ampo kita, never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession was left unaided. Pero, labaw sa tanan, bisan si Mama Mary Mengon, tungod siyang anak, Señor Santo Niño balani sa gugma, nga nahigugma nato og Mengon. We may be afraid, but our faith is stronger than our fear. Amen. Salamat, Señor Santo Niño. Sa imong dakong gugma. Padayon kining panaw sa pagtuo. Og, ang atong pangandoy, Señor Santo Niño, fountain of peace in our journey of faith. Sa atong panaw, ang atong damgo, ang atong pangandoy, kalinaw, peace. And what is peace? Normally, mingon kita, peace is the absence of war. Tinuod, no? Kaya kung maguna-una kita sa karon, subo kayo, epekto sa gerra. Bisan na lamang Russia and Ukraine agdaghan pa. No? Everybody felt the effect of war. Bisan na lagani sa bugas. Bisan na lagani sa sibuyas. No? Bisan na lagani. Tinuod, tanan kita. Joke nila niya ito, steak, 250. Karon ko may sibuyas, 950. No? Effect of war. Maong nga nagampo kita, bisan ang Santo Papa na ngayo, prayer. Kini, layo pa kita. What more, no? Kung dito sa Europe, what more kung dito sa Ukraine. We pray that peace may reign, especially in areas where there is war and hatred and definitely much pain because of war. Peace is the absence of war, of conflict. Pero karong buntaga, we are reminded to the more positive dimension of peace, because it basically means it's the harmonious relationship between kita og Dios, kita kada tagsa, kita og ang atong kalibutan, ecology. Karong buntaga, as we gather, we ask Señor Santo Niño to be with us so that first of all, we continue to strive that we may maintain that loving, intimate relationship with God. Matud pa, in a culture that tends to put God aside, in many cultures, because they think they can manage without God. Kita dinhi sa Pilipinas muingon, ang ninyo nga gidawat sa ating katigwangan, the ninyo that was accepted by our forefathers, is the ninyo that we love today, and we love to sing, "Yes, Señor Santo Niño, gidawat ka sa among katigwangan, we continue to accept you. You came, but you are here with us, no longer in the manger, but you are in our altars, you are in our home, you are in our churches, you are in our hearts." Amen?
Amen.
Relationship with God, relationship with the Señor Santo Niño. Nindot una-unaon. Lately, no, kining Niño, Santo Niño de Cebu, has been requested all over the world. From Spain, who brought it here. From Rome, the center of Christianity. In many parts of the U.S., in many parts of Asia, mao nga kining atong kaparian nga mga Agustino, they are asked to come to various parts of the world to lead in the celebration of Señor Santo Niño. Kay nga naman, because people have seen the faith of Cebu, the faith of the Filipinos, our love for Señor Santo Niño, and they want to know what makes us resilient in times of troubles and difficulties, and with what gives us the strength to keep on plodding and living despite the many trials. I, for one, accepted the invitation to go to Milan to be with Filipinos there. No? Pero ang atong punto, gipakita nato, pinangga kita ni Señor Santo Niño o pinangga nato siya? Mao nga malipayon kita pag pit Señor, malipayon kita pag sinulog, malipayon kita pag novena, nasayod kita, tuburan sa kalinaw, tuburan sa paglaom, tuburan sa mga gasa ng atong kinanglan sa atong kinabuhi. Amen?
Amen.
Viva Pit Señor! Harmonious relationship with God. In a culture that brushes God aside, kita sa Philippines mayon, "Lord, we need you. Lord, we love you. Stay with us. Stay with us in our families, in our homes, in our hearts." Kining peace, diha masugod. But we are asked, because as we all know, peace is a gift of God. And yet, peace is also a human construct. It is also a task. Mao nga sa atong bahin, paningkamot kita to establish peace by a brotherly relationship with one another. Nindot una-unaon panahon sa COVID, how many among you thought not only of your own families but of the many who are hungry, went to the different areas, assisted them with feeding, not just for a day, not just for a week, but for months? How many of you took the courage to go to the jails, to the hospitals? How many of you have truly went to the mountains? Nindot una-unaon. Brotherly relationship with one another. Mao kini ang peace. Harmonious relationship. Unta, as we journey in faith, unta mapadayon kini. We establish Caritas aron kining atong faith may be expressed in good works, because we say faith should be seen in good works. Now, of the over 100 parishes, we have already established Caritas, so that our efforts of love and service may be done systematically. Pero ang punto, matod pa ni St. Francis, let there be peace, and let it begin with me as we deal, as we relate, as we walk with, as we see sisters and brothers. Because as we often take pride, baptism, the first baptism happened in Cebu. Well, they may argue about the first mass, the first baptism happened in Cebu. Ug tungod niini, how inspiring to own and to be reminded, because of that wonderful event, I no longer look at one person as alien to me, but as a sister and brother. Tungod kay kitang tanan, binunyagan. Amen. Tungod kay kitang tanan, anak sa Dios. Amen. Tingali, lahi kulor siyang panit, lahi kulor siyang buhok. Ang iba, wa naman gani buhok. No? Pero, wa problema. No? We are all sisters and brothers. Amen. Amen. And that's the root of peace. Katapusang punto. How timely does our Holy Father remind us that peace should also be established between us and creation. Because we live in one home. Because we live in one planet Earth. I love to think just last week we gathered around 20 different religious denominations, communities, faith communities, lain-laing grupo, bayanihan sa kalikasan. It is a pledge of commitment to do the best we can in solidarity, kining pagtambayayong, kining pagsalmot, to work for our environment. And we have made that a pledge, transcending different religious affiliations. We know we can be united, never mind about which sect, religion, no? But for common cause that brings healing, that brings unity, that brings growth. Yes, we feel sad, we strike our breast, we have somehow in many ways destroyed, ransacked, and in fact maltreated our country, our planet. Yet it can be revived when we join hearts and voices and prayers and establish, we repeat, harmonious relationship with this world. Amen.
Amen.
Mga kaigsoonan, daghang nindot nga mga umaabot nga kayuhan. Kung uban ni Señor Santo Niño, padayon kita sa pag-ampo, padayon kita sa pagsalig, padayon kita sa pagsahad. We want peace. And according to the document of the Church, development is another name for peace. We are blessed with a wonderful land, but we have to take care of this land in collaboration with each other. And we know that Niño, who tells us we are all brothers and sisters, siya ang fountain, siya ang sinugdan, siya ang katumanan nining tanan. Sa atong pagpadayon sa atong misa, usbon ako, kinisingkasing ko gipadangat ninyo ang akong pagpasalamat sa mga tinuig nga naning kamot kita, taliwala sa lain-laing pagsulay, bangon Cebu, pagtinibangay, pagsalmat. On a personal note, as I look at the Niño, 25 years ago, when I was ordained bishop, His Eminence Cardinal Vidal said, Bishop Palma come to Cebu right after your ordination from Iloilo, because he will introduce me and Bishop John Du as Auxiliary Bishop of Cebu. That was 25 years ago, and the feast of the Señor Santo Niño. Maungaingon ko, Señor Santo Niño, ah, salamat. You know that I have pledged to in many ways follow you. Kay ikaw man ang among hari, ikaw man ang among manunubos, ikaw man ang giya sa among panaw. Yes, batubalani sa gugma, he may be small but he is great. He may be a little child but he has the love of a wonderful God. Amen. Kanyong tanan sa atong panaw, Señor Santo Niño, tuburan sa kalinaw sa atong panaw sa pagtuo. Salig kita niya o salig kita ngang umaabot tungod siyang grasya, gasa sa kalinaw, which means development, growth, change for the better as a church, as a community. Kanyong tanan, usbunako, Viva Pit Señor!
Viva
Pit Señor! Viva Señor Santo Niño!
Viva Señor Santo Niño!
Malipayong piyesta natong tanan.